We had a minor change in plans due to some heavy downpours out there in the field. So we're going to have everybody inside now. Whoops, switched cameras. All right. Go ahead.
Hi, everybody. This is Erin Cordes. Leslie and I are tag teams trying to get through this, help you bring this information to you for this webinar. What we wanted to do outside, but the weather wasn't allowing us to, was to interview some of the attendees of the webinar, of the Manure Expo, and bring their perspectives and what the Manure Expo means to them and what it could mean to others as well. With us in the room here are Precise Moderman. I'm sorry for that. She's an extension specialist with the University of Minnesota, and we have Doug Hamilton with Oklahoma State University. Reason I asked these two in here today is this is Christmas's first Manure Expo, and we think this is Doug's fifth.
Six.
Yes. So
the older I get, the less I remember.
So we have a couple different perspectives. Maybe first start with you, Doug. What do you look forward to each year at the Manure Expo?
Actually, one of the things I look forward to is just meeting with a bunch of people from around the country and actually the continent that share similar interest in manure. I know we're a little bit different group of people, but just getting to see everybody once or twice a year is what I look forward to.
I heard that comment outside, too, from another educator. She goes, where else can you go and have this much fun talking about manure? So, Chrissy, what were you really excited for when Manure Expo was coming up?
Well, you know, it's my first Manure Expo, and if 5 years ago, if you had asked me if I would be excited to go to a whole two-day expo about manure, I would have called you crazy. But, yeah, so I like meeting the new people. You're probably talking to people that you've seen many times. So I've met so many new people these last couple days, and I remember maybe 30% of their names, and it's been great, and reaching out and thinking about future collaborations is always great, too, and getting excited about future projects.
So, Doug, as you go to these expos, what is your favorite part of the expo each year? There's, of course, the educational sessions, there's the tours, education demonstration, the application demonstration, plus the trade show. What's your favorite
part? Oh, of course it's watching PowerPoint slides at the educational section. No, actually, my favorite part, and what one of the things I come back year after year is the tours. On the tour day, since it's in a different state or different province every year, you can see something completely different than what we'll do in Oklahoma or Missouri or someplace. So it's that variety of seeing a different thing every time in a different part of the country.
Thank you. And Chrissy, your first time here, what was your favorite part so far?
Well, we've done so much over the last couple days. And while you look down on the PowerPoint presentation, that's my favorite part, the educational sessions, and especially the ones that outline the research that they've done. And so you can see what's done in different parts of the country and what might seem crazy to do in, like, Minnesota, where I'm from, you know, like, oh, well, you know, they're doing that somewhere else. And it kind of expands your horizons and tempers your expectations.
So my last question for both of you, what new information are you leaving here with?
Well, actually, right before the storm struck, I got enough of the solid equipment demonstration. And actually, that's what I'm going to leave with, because I'm working right now on doing a fact sheet series about solid applicators. And down in Oklahoma, we've been concentrating on poultry litter applicators, which are a little bit different than some of the vertical beaters, horizontal beaters you see up here. So it was good to see some different equipment, see how they spread patterns and whatnot. So that's what I'm going to leave with. I'll go back to Stillwater and start typing away on a new fact sheet.
Great. And for me, my well of knowledge is probably far shallower than yours, Doug. But from the educational sessions, I was really excited to learn about the cover crops aspect of manure applications in Minnesota, especially for kind of just getting into that, and cover crops are such an exciting topic, and whenever we talk to our audiences, when you bring up cover crops, you're like, oh, I'm so excited. So to learn about that and more about their nitrogen holding capacities and those sorts of things is really interesting.
I appreciate your perspective and sharing those today, and as you can see, we have a whole different generation of manure experts in the room, but
I used to be the young guy.
But everybody's coming away with something. When we were out in the field, it was a quick tour around seeing all the different equipment, but there were several people out there, producers or applicators, looking at the equipment, you know, trying to make decisions based on some of the features they were seeing for some future purposes. So there's something here for everybody. Again, like